Okay, this is Dr. Krause. I've had some issues trying to download some or record some screen videos to help my students, and trying a different software. Hopefully this works. It's an old laptop running Windows 7. We'll see what happens. So we need to download the Raspbian operating system, which will be a zip file that we will unzip into a .img file, which we will then copy to an SD card. And so first thing I want you to do, if you haven't already done so, is to Google Raspbian download. That's R-A-S-P-B-I-A-N. And that will take you to this website, which is on raspberrypi.org/downloads. And if you click the little spiral guy, that's the Raspbian. Two options here. You can download that as a zip file, which I would do, and then just make sure you know where that's saving to. Your browser may choose, let you choose a save location, or it may just force you to save into mydocuments/downloads or something. Either way, you need to know where that zip file is. Try that first. If the zip file doesn't behave well, and it's a big download, so it could get interrupted for any number of reasons, then try to download using a BitTorrent. And if you're going to do that, Google Windows BitTorrent Client. And there's an article here on howtogeek.com, and so it explains why they would no longer recommend MicroTorrent, which now apparently has a bunch of ads and some other things that are kind of maybe a little bit sketchy. And so I've had good luck with Deluge, or however you pronounce that, and there's another one on here called Transmission or something. And so either of those have worked well for me. Somehow get the zip file downloaded onto your computer. Then the next step, once you know, okay, so here's that website's ready, and it's not ready. Okay, never mind. Once you have the zip file and you know where it is, and I put that on an external drive. First of all, the zip file will be about 1.5 gigabytes, and then the unzipped file is like 4 gigabytes. So make sure you're saving these onto hard drives where you have that kind of space. And so if you double-click the zip file and just hit Extract All Files in Windows, it'll ask you where you want to extract it and just start extracting it. On my computer, because I was doing this on an external hard drive, and maybe it's an old computer, and maybe I have some virus scanning thing going on, it took about 20 minutes to unzip that. So just hit the Extract All Files button, give it a location, hit Extract, and that will happen. So then once you have that extracted, and I guess I should show you what that looks like extracted, it'll be a .img file for image, and like I said, it is just under 4 gigabytes on my computer. So we want to copy that to an SD card. So if you were to Google Raspberry Pi SD install Windows, I want to draw your attention to the first and fourth link. So the first link is on the raspberrypi.org/documentation website, and it tells you to mount your SD card and then use something called the Win32 disk imager. So if you were to click on this link, it takes you to this page, and if you click this green download button, it'll start to save an exe file for Win32 disk imager. We'll talk about that in just a second. The other page, back over here on Google, the fourth link was our Pi Easy SD card setup on elinux.org, and there's instructions here for Windows, Mac OS X, and Linux, and so we'll talk about those other ones in future videos. So yeah, you have the unzipped.img file, you've installed Win32 disk imager, and we're almost ready to install it. Now what I want you to do at this point is go back to Windows Explorer and make a note of all the drive letters that are available to you. So I've got a C, a D, and an E. It's crucial that you know what those are, because when we mount the SD card, if you tell the Win32 disk imager to install to the wrong drive, it could majorly damage your computer and erase lots of important stuff. So one, I would probably recommend ejecting any drives that you're using as backups, like flash drives or whatever. And then I'm going to plug in my SD card and pay attention to what happens here, what new letter pops up. And so apparently my SD card is on the G drive. And the other thing that will happen when I open G, I see that there's nothing in there because this is a brand new fresh micro SD card. And if I were to right click on it and ask for its properties, It'll show up with a little familiar Windows pie chart, which is almost entirely empty. It's got 32 gigabytes used and 14.4 gigabytes free. So it's a 16 gigabyte micro SD card. Apparently I don't get all 16 of that, but it's essentially 100% empty and it's ready. And so that's on the G drive. It's very important that I know that it's on the G drive. Then I take the Windows 32 disk imager that I've installed, and it's going to pop up and it's going to ask me where the image file is. So first I'm going to click this little folder and browse to where I know I have that .emg file, which is on my external hard drive, my Jesse folder. There it is. And then it's asking for my device designation. And we said that was the G drive. Very, very important that you're 1,000% sure that you have the right drive before you click this button. Because as it'll say here in a minute, when I click right, doing this could majorly corrupt the G drive. Am I sure I want to continue? And I know that the G drive is my micro SD. And so yes, I'm sure. And now that'll start, and that may take several minutes, maybe even longer. So mine is, I think, a class 10, I don't know. So depending on the class of your SD card, your write speed, probably in the neighborhood of 15 megabytes per second would be good. And we know that we're writing 4 gigabytes. So 4 gigabytes is 4,000 megabytes divided by 10 or 15, means that it should take about 400 seconds. So that's gonna progress. I'm not gonna keep the video going, but when it's done, it would pop up a little message, hopefully, that says success. And then I'd be ready to eject that and put it in my Raspberry Pi and try to boot from it. Thanks.